A 29-year-old from Seattle is the main suspect in a murder spree from New Jersey to Washington State. Authorities say Ali Muhammad Brown was focused on one thing, vengeance. Law enforcement say Brown told a New Jersey police investigator his mission is vengeance for the millions of lives lost every day in Iraq, Syria, and Afghanistan. Police say between April and June, Brown killed three people in Washington State, allegedly shooting them at close range, and another in New Jersey. According to court documents, Brown confessed to investigators he strictly follows the Muslim faith. If you haven't heard about this story, you're not alone. Very few media outlets are covering it. Tim Graham of the Media Research Center joins us now with more. Tim, why are we not seeing more media outlets covering this story?
I'm sure they want to tell you it's a local crime story, but I think anybody who watches the networks, ABC, CBS, and NBC, knows they love local crime stories. For example, this morning they were, this isn't even a crime story, but it's a local story. When you have a tour bus that goes off the road, in Delaware, that's somehow a national story. So obviously you can't say, well, we don't do local stories. I think in this case, it just has it has this whole element of, well, we don't really want to tell another story about violent Muslims.
Interesting. Well, who is covering the story?
Well, Fox News is covering it, and again, CNN has been covering this story. So CNN, which likes to present itself as middle of the road, does seem to be doing something here that doesn't have that liberal sensitivity that says, we don't really want to tell stories that might scare the American people about Muslims, even if they're true stories about someone who's motivated to kill Americans based on our foreign policy.
Let's talk about the big picture here. How big of a story is this? What are the national implications or even the global implications of this?
Well, I think, first of all, I think if we had a Republican president, they might find it a more interesting story because they wanted George Bush's foreign policy to be controversial. At this particular point, Barack Obama's numbers on foreign policy are pretty poor. And so I think this is one of those things that they don't really want to bring attention to that. I think it might remind some people of the D.C. sniper case, which was not really politically motivated. But that really captured the national media's attention. And of course, having lived in this area during that, I mean, the entire public was really scared by it. So I think the fact that it's one of those things that happens sometimes. If nobody ever picks it up, or if only a few media people pick it up, it never gains momentum. Whereas once it establishes momentum, then you can't get the story to go away. That's kind of what's happened here.
Let's suppose the alleged killer professed to strictly follow the Christian faith. Would it then get all kinds of attention by the media?
It might. I think that, again, if it had this sort of a political sound to it, let's say, for example, the very easy example is if a Christian decided to murder abortion doctors or abortion clinic workers, it would be a massive story. We can certainly tell you, based on our research back in the 1990s, that a few incidents of abortion doctors being shot and or killed got hundreds of network news stories, more than 500 between 1993 and 1997. So I think we can say any sort of Christian violence of a political nature would have to get more, you would expect it to get more coverage than this.
Well, can viewers do anything, Tim, to prod the networks and cable outlets to cover stories like this?
I think so. I think this is one of those stories where it is possible that they're not aware of this story. If it doesn't come from the sources that they like best, which sometimes can be either liberal newspapers like the New York Times or the liberal blogs that they like Slate or the Huffington Post, it's possible that they haven't seen it. So the first thing on a story like this is, yes, if you send media outlets saying, where is this story, might actually cause them to discover it.
Okay. Tim Graham of the Media Research Center, thank you, sir, for your time and insight today.
You bet.